can type that.
Hi, Chingu. Annyeong.
Oh. Okay, that is interesting. Kind of boozy, but like in a nice way. Like, just smells like a very sophisticated drink. This is...
Hi, hello. It's a Wednesday. I've got dinner plans, which is rare, because I'm usually at home eating my sad chicken nugget salad. So this is a fit. It's kind of boho-y. I got this wrinkled shirt, jeans, and this jacket here. Turtleneck, of course, with the woad necklace. How do we like that? Yeah, having my like farewell week before I go back home to America. Like, this is the situation right now. Yeah. So, doing the most here, doing the most. But it should be nice. Let's go.
Because reading is sexy, and if you're not reading, you're not sexy. Here with some updates. The major one is I'm going back to LA like this weekend, and kind of nerve-wracking because, you know, just like overall travel, like it's a 10-hour flight, which isn't so bad. And am I done packing? No, I'm not. I'm gonna stay one night in Seoul tomorrow and then fly out on Sunday. Today's Friday. And yeah, kind of excited. I have been working really long hours and I just deserve a vacation. Because everyone deserves rest. Rest is incredibly important. Hustle culture, sure, do your thing, but I love me some rest, you know? It doesn't seem like I sleep on this channel. I do. I really do, and I value sleep a lot. I don't do much of it, but I'm going to be restful for this trip, and among other things. But, like, yeah, I'm gonna rest, and that's healthy. Okay. Book updates. I don't know if I've talked about it, but I read Street Cop by Robert Coover from Isolary Books. Oh, and Art Spiegelman. It's a neo-noir about a cop who's hired on the spot and sort of travels around the city getting into some shenanigans. It's quick, it's fun, it's repulsive, but in like a fun way. Yeah, not enough art, actually. I was hoping for more Art Spiegelman. If anyone doesn't know, Art Spiegelman's a graphic novelist. And yeah, there's just, I was expecting more art, but there's a lot more writing from Robert Coover, who I haven't read, but having looked him up on Goodreads, he writes some pretty interesting stuff in sort of the Dennis Cooper transgressive lit field. And yeah, really interesting. It's fun. It's quirky. Not a lot to think about. There's like some weird boomer social critique on Siri, which is weird. I don't know why. But other than that, it's a fun one. It's fun. It's quick. I think I brought this out clubbing one night and yeah, read it on the bus at like 4 a.m. It was fun. Kept me awake. Robert Coover, Art Spiegelman, Street Cop. Yeah. And then I decided to pick up I Was the President's Mistress by Miguel C. Juco. Yes, Filipino author. And I realized I don't think I've read any Filipino literature. So this is a real treat. Before, I wasn't enjoying it so much. The first 100 pages was a lot of like investigative. It took a long time for Miguel to characterize our protagonist, Vita Nova, who is this introverted megastar. She's like a influencer who gets into all of these scandals with people in politics. And yeah, it's all written in like transcripts of her in an interview. And that's the whole book. Among other transcripts from people in politics, religion, and so forth. Took a while to get to where it needed to go, and now I'm enjoying it. I was going to DNF it, but I was like, you know what? I haven't read Filipino literature. Let me give it a chance and let me finish it. I know life's short, but also I'm a really firm believer in reading voices that I haven't read. So I already have settled thoughts on this book, so I will stop talking about this book now. I've decided what to bring with me to America. Some books. Let's take a look. I am bringing Stoner by John Williams, because I'm doing a buddy read with Seren. So going to bring this along once I finish I Was the President's Mistress. And then, I don't know, just like a really, like, airports, hotels, just really I can't speak today. I haven't spoken, I guess, in a really long time. I don't know why I can't speak. Airports, hotels, really transitory spaces. I'm moving places. I'm going places. I thought, why not pick up a Lispector book? A Breath of Life, Clarice Lispector. This is her final novel that was to be seen published. And I think I'm handing this over to Sophie at Bibliosophie. So excited to hand deliver this to her and see her, of course. As we are trying to read more Lispector. And I think we're also going to try and read more Eileen Miles and Patti Smith as well, since I'll be in New York. So yes, hope to eat this up as well. I am being really ambitious with these books. Like, I'm only halfway through. And this book's like about 300 pages. I'm like, how am I gonna read all these books? Also, I'm bringing my Kindle, of course, because you never know. What books do I got on here? Let's see. I have a couple of ARCs from NetGalley, maybe more than I can handle, but one is The Guest by Emma Klein. I've always wanted to read Daddy by Emma. What is it? I think it's like that pink font, just says Daddy on like a yellow cover. I'm just like, yes, yes, I want to read that in public. I don't want people to shame me and point at me. That's exactly what I want. I have Island City by Laura A. I think Ben read this and he thoroughly enjoyed it on like an emotional level. So interested in that. I also have YN, who, I'm forgetting who that's by, but I think it's Esther Yu. If not, I'll have the correction here. CJ Reeds read this, as well as Alex from What Page Are You On? And they both gave it some really, they gave it a lot of stars, so I'm really curious to see what that is. And did I talk about Saving Time? Saving Time. I have Saving Time by Jenny Odell, which I got like long time ago last year, I think November, and I really need to read that because I think it's getting, or I think it's already published. So it's not an ARC anymore. And I also have Deep as the Sky, Red as the Sea, written by an Asian American author whose name escapes me now, because I don't know why, but if you look, it just doesn't have, it says unknown. Like, why does it do that? I'll have the author name here though. And yeah, compelled by the cover, looks like a lot of fun. So yes, those are all the books I'm bringing with me. And I have some books at home as well waiting for me. So whew, we got a lot of reading to do. Every January I do this, I like overwhelm myself. And for the most part, I'm pretty good about it. But then it's like February, March, I kind of like die off. Because I put all my eggs in one basket. I really shouldn't. But yeah, as far as like movies and books go, we're doing pretty good. I think I have 4 books done already. And 8 movies? I think I've done 8 movies so far. So we're doing pretty good, I think. Yeah. Okay. Before I blabber on too long, those are the updates. I need to finish packing, you know, do last minute stuff. And yeah. Next time I update y'all, I'll be stateside. California lovin', here I come. I miss California. But it's mostly gonna be chill, cause I've got some things planned and I just, you know, I need the calm before the storm. Just, yeah. Anyway, hope you're doing well. Why do I always do that? I always say, anyway, hope you're doing well. And then the next thing I say is, be well. That's my tagline. Be well, do good work, keep in touch.
Hi, hello, one last shot from the dirty mirror. It's time to go to LA. Well, going to Seoul for one night and then LA. But yeah, I'm all packed. I have 2 giant suitcases and 1 giant carry-on. And I hope nothing is like over the weight limit. But yeah, this is the basic fit that I'll wear 2 days in a row. Yes, got the rest and recreation scarf hoodie thing. Vintage black trench, my friend's jeans, the cropped sweater. Oh, and of course, nothing written suede bag, which is kind of dangerous to bring out because it's supposed to rain. How am I gonna lug 3 bags through the rain? Wish me luck. Today, I'm meeting a friend at a gallery. Well, first I have to check into the hotel, drop my stuff off, then go get a film camera, just a disposable one. I can't be trusted with the real one. And then I'm meeting a friend for a gallery, maybe coffee. And then after that, I just have like tiny errands to do and then meeting a friend for like an early dinner. And then I'm just gonna chillax cause I don't wanna be hungover or drunk and miss my flight. We are responsible. Yep, no clubbing till 6 a.m. Not today, Satan. So yeah, that's the look. That's what we're doing today. Anyway, let's go. Hi, it's your boy Nate. I'm at the hotel finally. I think I did a terrible job vlogging today. But to recap, had a bunch of errands in the morning and then met my friend for coffee, had a really good chat, caught up, it was very nice. And then went to dinner with my friend and the restaurant was fine. It's just one of those places where like the plates are kind of expensive and the portions were small. So we went to another restaurant afterwards and got done and it was good. It was fine. Had a fab time. Chill. But it's already 10 p.m. and I'm just like, where the hell did all the time go? But yeah, I'm at my favorite hotel in Seoul. If you have a bit to splurge, it's fantabulous. It's the Rise Hotel in Hongdae. It's convenient because it's right next to, like, pretty accessible to Incheon Airport. So it's, and the airport line runs through here. It's just perfect. For everyone's first time in Seoul, I totally think Hongdae is like the perfect place. It's got the essence, the vibrancy of Seoul. And it's just a very youthful part of the city. Yeah. Hotel tour? Anybody? Yeah. Okay. Let's take you along.
Immediately upon entering, you have this great circular mirror, a little place for your little essentials. And then to the left is the bathroom. Very nice. A toilet, very important, and the shower. Now this room is interesting because the shower is directly next to the bedroom, but there's a little thing that you can pull down, so it's not as sexy. But yes, and what's really nice is that they have their own toiletry. Can I do this one-handed? I kind of want to keep this case. I don't know if I can, but got your essentials here. Very nice. Yeah, it's just a fantabulous restroom. Okay, and then a little coat rack situation here. Sorry, my mess. Speaker, kettle, there's a fridge in there. And then you have the bedroom, which is nice. And then what I love is this little love seat. So if you can totally fit like 1, 2, 3, 4 fifth person. And if you have a child or something, a child could go there. And they got me little snacks, isn't that cute? Love that. I don't know if I'll eat that. And then face masks, of course. And then I'll shoot in the morning to show you the view. You really can't see it very well at night, but yeah. Okay, we're back in this angle. I shouldn't have, but I did some shopping. Well, first stops first. I got a film camera because I can't be trusted with a real camera. I run through so many Olympus Pen point and shoots that it's ridiculous. I think I ran through 4 and I broke all of them. It's not that I'm a careless person, it's just I'm moving oot and a boot constantly. So plastic's the way to go for me. I know, not good for the environment, but it's better than, you know, spending $20 to $70 on a new film camera like every few months. And then I went to numbering. I just thought this would be really nice to have as an accessory. My last accessory, I promise. I feel like I have too many accessories, but sterling silver looks like a watch, but is in fact not. It's a little bracelet. Black leather, sterling silver. I would take it, should I take it out? I guess I should. I'll show you real quickly. But you can see their logo on the back there. I don't know if that'll show. That won't show. Just a really cute accessory. Can I just show you like this? Do I actually have to put it on? No. Okay, that's all you're getting. Because I'm too lazy to put it on. But yeah, just thought that would be a really nice accessory. And that's it, I swear, no more shopping. Because we gotta save, like truly save. I'm gonna catch some Z's because my flight is tomorrow at 11 a.m. So, gonna wake up early,
like 6 a.m. as I always do, it's my body alarm. And then read a bit, vlog a bit maybe, a little coffee, some breakfast, and then come to the airport 4 hours early because I'm insane. And I do not want to miss my flight at all, at any cost. I will not, shall not, because I spent a ridiculous amount of money on it. Now I just seem insane. Maybe TMI, but whenever I go travel, like long distances, I have like a mini panic attack. So I had a panic attack earlier today at a clothing store that sells like contemporary Korean clothes, like K-style fashion. It's like mid-range, high-end kind of clothes. It's a bit pricey, but I just like going in there sometimes just for to see like what the trends are and see if things align within my own philosophy. I don't buy into trends so much. I like what I like, and if I see what I like, I'll get it. But I was just curious about what was trending, and yeah. Just had like a sort of mini panic attack, and in the middle of the store where they were playing like thumping 2014's Forever 21 kind of music, and woo, that was a moment. But that happens to me every time I like travel long distance, because I don't know, it's just like the whole pressure of transitory spaces, places, and faces. It's just, yeah. I don't know. I'm excited to go home. I'm excited to see my family. Excited to see my friends, catch up, but also kind of like chill, you know? To go back to my childhood bedroom and sit in silence. Yeah. Okay. Before I become completely sentimental and become a mess of tears, a puddle of myself. Yeah. Next time I see you, it'll be stateside. It's happening. This is real. Feels not real. Hope everything goes well. Yeah.
Hi. Hello. Sorry if this is a weird angle. Obviously. On my skincare routine, but I just finished. I was the president's mistress. Let me tell you, when Kieran says to trust your gut and DNF a book, just do it. Don't ask me why. I thought of DNFing this at like page 57 or something, but I still kept going. And by the 200 page mark or 100 page mark, it started to get like really interesting because it got into sort of the socio-political atmosphere of the Philippines and sort of how these corrupt leaders take advantage of people and our main character, Vita Nova. And yeah, just really interesting things, because this is based off of a lot of contemporary Filipino issues, and yeah, I was really interested in that, but it just lugged on and on in this like really gossipy format that, and by the end, it's really interesting the way it ends. It's just, I don't know, Miguel DiJuco? I don't know. I will say, before turning on the camera, I don't know, I had to like immediately look up interviews and other reviews, and in this one talk that he gave, I'll link it below, but he said that this novel, when he finished it and he was rereading it, he said he fell asleep. When you write something that's completely boring and you edit from that, I don't know. So little that is interesting can only come up from that. And like, I'm so disappointed. I can't believe I finished this. I can't believe I spent this much time reading this. As you can tell, completely infuriated, destroyed this copy. It's hideous now. Now still such a gorgeous cover. Whoever designed this is incredible, but I'm disappointed and I'm so angry. I'm kind of like, flustered, but like, it takes Miguel 100 pages of poor characterization of Vita Nova to get to sort of the interesting elements of what is going on with power structures, people in power, and the hierarchies between
man and women, definitely battle of the sexes. And it almost like totally mimics, or what's the word I'm looking for? Insults the female body or the female character of Vita Nova. I just feel like she was just portrayed as this like ditzy social media influencer who is like trying to be a feminist and maneuver herself in this like man-made world without like being interesting about it. Like, there wasn't a single part where I like felt empathy for her. And I don't know, it's just like really poor characterization on Miguel's part. Incredibly disappointing. Mad 2 stars. Who is this for? I feel like if you are Filipino-American and are curious about the Filipino landscape and like the social political structure of it and the people in power, you'll get a lot out of that, as well as a lot of like Tagalog that's used in here mixed with English. The references are really fun, but at a certain point I felt like Miguel was writing in these jokes that either hit or miss, and most of them miss. The rest of the book just falls flat, but it's written in transcripts of Vita Nova in this like confessional gossipy way, along with the people in power that she was in relationships with, scandalous relationships with. Other than that, like, I think it's interesting in concept, just wasn't executed properly in the narrative format. Yeah. Like, fun in structure and all, but poor novelization and story formation. I don't know. I don't think it works, essentially. It's like reading the Watergate tapes. But I'm glad I crunched through this, because I think I already mentioned it, but not enough Filipino literature in the world, and I should read more. And this was my first piece of Filipino literature, and yeah. I'm done. I'm done with this. I don't even want to look at it anymore. So I think I'm going to start A Breath of Life by Clarice Lispector, and to put myself just in that state of mind, be inebriated by metaphysical existential despair. Anybody else? And then I really need to get to Stoner by John Williams, because Seren has started and I need to play catch up. This seems pretty slim though, so we'll read this and then get to John Williams. Yes, we are crunching through. Yeah, got a good balance of bad reads and good reads so far, I think. Okay, hope you're well. Do your skincare. Hi. It's the next day. I'm about ready to leave. It takes 40 minutes by taxi from the hotel to the airport. We are doing good on time. I'm ready. Putting on my valuables. Because always travel with your valuables. You never want them to get lost. Started this last night. Oof. So bleak. Clarice was writing A Breath of Life near the end of her days, where she couldn't even physically write it. Her assistant, Olga, had to transcribe her words for her. And it's very, very bleak and depressing. Can I read you this? I write as if to save somebody's life, probably my own. Life is a kind of madness that death makes. Long live the dead, because we live in them. Suddenly, things no longer need to make sense. I'm satisfied with being, are you? Certainly you are. The meaninglessness of things make me smile complacently. Everything surely must go on being what it is. And not gonna lie, kinda spiraling, woo! But you also see a lot of what she's thinking in her last days, and I guess what most people think about in their last days, and Yeah, it's quite something. I love her. She's my religion. If anyone has forgotten, we worship Clarice Lispector on this channel. And yeah, please read Lispector, because she will change your life. She is an experience, a holy experience. Okay, this is it. This is it. Probably gonna have a mental breakdown at the airport, anybody? yeah, but let's go. See you stateside, people.